What is it that you are aiming for as a believer? The true answer should be? The true answer should be? Jannah. I hope everyone said it. Paradise. That's what we want. In this world, we will struggle. In this world, we will go through lots of difficulty. We spoke about it yesterday. Many of the other speakers spoke about the same. But we need to realize, if you want paradise, there is a way of getting it. The Prophet ﷺ says, "Ala inna sil'ata Allahi ghaliyah." Behold, the commodity of Allah is expensive. What is the commodity? It is Jannah. And I've always given an example of a person who's bought a house. Higher purchase or mortgage. They are paying on a monthly basis, installments. When you miss one payment, what happens? You might be fined. You miss two or three payments, you can lose the house. Even if you've paid for 2-3 years, or 5 years, or 10 years, you miss a few payments, there is a possibility of you losing the house. What happens with Jannah? Every salah is a payment. It is a payment for a house that is far more valuable than these houses in Damansara. It's a reality. It is a serious payment. Every time you miss a salah, default. Every time you miss one prayer, you're losing out on your house. And if you miss more, you might lose that house completely. This is why, if you have aspirations, you are a person who wants to achieve the utmost, and that is paradise. You need to get up and do something about it. Make a payment. What is the payment? When there is a sin that is to be committed, you stay away and you say, "Oh Allah, this is because I want Jannah. I will please you. I know there are so many things that I would be able to do on earth that would displease you. I won't do it because my aim is to please you, oh Allah, so that you can be pleased with me." Have you heard the verse of the Quran where Allah describes some of the companions, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. Allah is pleased upon them, they are pleased with Allah, and Allah has prepared for them paradise. To be pleased with Allah and for Him to be pleased with you is something unique. That is when you will definitely achieve paradise. But to be able to earn the pleasure of Allah, you need to pay. Pay in what way? Abstain from prohibitions that He has told you, and engage in that which is compulsory, obligatory upon you. And on top of that, start fulfilling acts that are not compulsory, but they would earn the pleasure of Allah. So a lot of us, mashallah, we fulfill our 5 daily prayers, alhamdulillah. But it's just the farad. We are quick to start, quick to end, and we are gone. Farad. That's it. Why don't you increase it? Because I want to earn the pleasure of Allah. Start reading your sunnah. Start reading your nafil. Take your time about things. Make wudu correctly. This is called aiming high. But the problem is sometimes we don't think of where we're going. If you sit and pause for a moment and ponder over your own life and your age and the fact that you are becoming older, and you witness the others who have already gone forth to the hereafter, you will realize, I need to prepare before I go. More for the hereafter than I am for the rest of this life.